Praise your name, never's love of my Lord never cease. Never come to my day
every morning.
New every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Oh Lord, I be
grateful.
That is why he is Lord. He is Lord.
Amen.
He has risen from the dead. He is Lord. Every thought of that Jesus Christ is the Lord.
From the dead is
every name of every tongue of that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Salvation to my God, you seated on the throne, hands to the Lamb forever. Salvation to my God, seated on the throne that day. Thanks to the Lamb forevermore. Salvation to my God, seated on the throne. Thanks to the Lord forevermore. Let's open our mouth and worship Him. Open your mouth and worship Him. Give Him praise.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We give you praise, Lord.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we want to say thank you.
Thank you.
Lord, we give you praise.
Amen.
This is the day that you have made.
Yes, Lord.
We rejoice and be glad in it, Lord.
Amen.
Father, we have come to pray.
Amen.
Answer all speedily in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Answer all speedily in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, tonight, let power change down in our life.
Amen.
Let power change down in our life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let our prayer be answered.
Amen.
In the name of the Father.
Amen.
And of the Son.
Amen.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You are welcome. Welcome to the day. We are the fifth day. Are we in number five? Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Okay. We are number five. We are the five. The fasting, the 30 days fasting and prayer. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And I know that before the end of this 30 days, God will visit you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say God will visit you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every power that is hindering God from visiting you, that power will die in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That power that don't allow God to manifest in your life, those power must be buried alive in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That power that don't want your dream to come true, that power will be buried alive in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That power of delay shall receive fire in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
For prayer shall be answered today.
Amen.
I say your prayer shall be answered today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Remember that we started the prayer last yesterday. We look at what the Bible talk about. Suffer not a wish to live. Suffer not a wish to live. We want to see one place here before we go quickly. First Samuel chapter 28. First Samuel chapter 28. First Samuel chapter 28. First Samuel chapter 28. It's still there.
From verse 1, sir.
From verse 2.
Okay, I read in Jesus' name. And David says to Achish, surely and thou shalt know.
Continue.
Thou shalt know what thy servant can do.
Mm.
And Achish said to David, therefore will I make thee keeper of my head forever. Now Samuel was dead, and all Israel had lamented him and buried him in Ramah, even in his own city. And Saul had put away those that had familiar spirit and the wizard out of the land.
I want you to notice that Samuel was a prophet. Samuel was a prophet that they always go to consult with. But Samuel was dead. Then Saul, instead of him to seek God, he went, you see what Saul did. But this Saul, according to the Bible, what God said, he has already put away all witchcraft, all witches and wizards. He's supposed to kill them. He put them away. He has killed some, but only one person escaped. There was only one person that escaped because he has killed them. God said, suffer not. Exodus chapter 22, verse 18. Suffer not a wish to live. Please continue, please.
Verse 4.
Yes.
And the Philistines gathered themselves together and came and pinched in Shunem.
Yes.
And Saul gathered all Israel together. Mm. And they pinched in Gibeon. But five, and when Saul saw the host of the Philistines, he was afraid and his heart greatly trembled. And when Saul inquired of the Lord answered him not, neither by dreams, nor by Urim, nor by prophets. Then verse seven, then said Saul unto the servant, seek me a woman that had a familiar spirit, that I may go to her and inquire of her. And his servant said to him, behold, there is a woman that had a familiar spirit at Endor. And Saul disguised himself and put on other raiment. And put on other raiment. And he went, and two men with him. And they came to the woman by night. And he said, I pray thee, divine unto me by the familiar spirit, and bring me him up, whom I shall name unto thee. Verse 9. And the woman said unto him, behold, Samuel was Saul had done, how he had cut off those that have familiar spirits, and the wizard out of the land. Wherefore then lay thou his name for my life to cause me to die? And Saul swear to her by the Lord, saying, as the Lord liveth, there shall no punishment happen to thee for this thing. Then said the woman, whom shall I bring up unto thee? And he said, bring me up Samuel. And when the woman saw Samuel, she cried with a loud voice, and the woman spake to Saul, saying, why hast thou deceived me? For thou art Saul. And the king said unto her, be not afraid, for what said thou? And the woman said unto Saul, I saw God ascending thee out of the earth. And he said unto her, what form is he of? And she said, an old man cometh up, and is covered with a mantle. And Saul perceived that it was Samuel. And he stooped with his face to the ground and bowed himself. And Samuel said to Saul, why hast thou disquieted me?
Just stop there. What I'm trying to bring out is that there is not supposed to be witchcraft. Saul put all the witches away, because witch is not supposed to be existing on the earth. If you allow the witch to live, it will kill you. It will kill your destiny. You will not be able to achieve your goal. I'll tell you about a story, and we're going to pray, about a boy called Laiwowe. I don't know, my time is so fast then. Boy is called Laiwowe. Laiwowe was a very clever boy. Laiwowe means, he doesn't look at, but that is his name. He doesn't look at book. When you say one times one, Laiwowe will tell you the answer. The Yoruba, Laiwowe means, he doesn't look at book. That is his name. When you say four times four, Laiwowe will not look at the times table, will tell you the answer. This boy got distinguished. This boy passed. He got A's in his secondary school. Got all the distinction in secondary school. Laiwowe got an admission to study in university in London. He did the exam and he passed the exam very well. And everybody was very happy with Laiwowe. Everybody was very happy with him. The father did party for him that his son is going to abroad to study because he won the scholarship. After the party, they drank, they drew everything. The sister was the one escorting him to the airport. The sister put her head in her chest. He said, choose between your head or your education. But the sister had drank a lot of alcohol because it was over 90 the next morning. He was just laughing. Laiwowe went to England. He did well. He beat all the white people in England. He's a good swimmer. He won an award in swimming. The very day that they want to give Laiwowe his award, we say, let him just go and relax. Go to the swimming pool and go and relax. We don't know how Laiwowe missed his effort. You know that thing where they jump before you swim? If one swim, that way they bounce, that wood where they bounce. And do you know that what I'm saying? Like, we don't know how Laiwowe missed his step. From up there, Laiwowe hit on the pavement. His head was on one side. His body was on the other side. They have to use nylon to pack Laiwowe's head and his body to Nigeria. sister was crying at the airport, was rubbing her body at the airport. After many years, because the two last week I'm telling you, after many years, the sister came to the mountain on fire to confess. Because that man, Liveaway, was a friend to one of the pastors in the mountain of fire. It was because of the confession. They know that it was the sister that killed Liveaway because of the confession. Look at it. Liveaway has been wasted, but his sister has given her life to Christ. I want to tell you the greatest is that listen to me. That woman will go to heaven. But Liveaway have been wasted. Lift your hand towards heaven. Say after me. Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Power. I want to waste my life. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I want you to understand. I'm not arrogant. I'm not violent like this before. Now something that pushed me like this. I don't have time to explain to you. I'm a type of person that I'm so gentle. I just say, don't disturb me. I don't disturb you. Yes. Now problem that make me be like this. And you don't know, best way get problem is not a gentleman. True of us.
Yes. True.
That's true.
Best way get problem is not a gentleman. They say this man too. You are not a gentleman. You are not when you are when things are, you not be gentleman. You they misbehave. You
are not
a gentleman. Praise the Lord. Let me not gentle like this. And I make me not gentle like this. You must be violent. Some people may not like this kind of prayer. Some people can, you can even shut up your mouth. You can close your mouth. It doesn't matter. It's not anything. But I want you to know that everybody have enemies. Whether you like it or whether you believe, just know that you have enemies. Even God himself have enemies. The Bible says, let God arise, let his enemy be scattered. So something must be strong with you and say you don't have enemies. You may not pray the prayer, but that one is not your prayer. If you are praying for your enemy to live, you can pray for your wish to live. That is not a problem. It's not a problem. But me, it's better they die and they are alive.
Yes.
If you don't make any wish kill me, it's better make the wish die and make me die alive. I have a lot of things to do for God. I never finished the gospel. Why would the wish kill me? Tell me why wish will kill me. It will be powerless of me. Maybe the wish is in a wish killer. It will be very stupid of me to say now one wish killer. One man, one missionary was preaching. He said, pray. He goes, pray, you just pray, we just check your body like this. Now pray, you just pray, we check your body. So God come wicked, we know the answer you. One day now he go one village, go preach. He goes, you don't preach the preach where they preach. He said, if there's any wish, you let them hear. Wait, anyways, man, come out.
Mm-mm.
And he's not a prayerful person. Do you know that? When he sleep in the morning, he don't know the ad that they put up for main road. When he wake up, he see himself for main road. Then he see himself. He wake up. When he wake up, he see himself. He inside room he sleep, but he see himself for main road in the morning. He see himself for main road. Then people say, Baba, go do something for your life, oh. Go and take care of your life. Go and take care of your life. Please, you don't joke. You don't know what this Mr. Devil. You don't need to joke with this Mr. Devil. If you are a spiritual warfare person, if God they open your eyes, you will see what is happening in the spiritual realm at night. There are many transactions at midnight. many times, if you are a civilian warfare, you see many transactions. You will see flying, people flying. You will see astrologers. You will see different people. Fortune tellers. Look at the Bible. Bible says fortune tellers. Spirit. So goes when they go consult. Bring soul spirit, come down. Ah, say after me. Say, my father, my father.
My father.
Every power. Every witch and wizard. I want to bring me down. Please pray this prayer again. Say after me. Just pray two more people. Don't after me. Say after me. Say, my father, my father. Any witches or witch doctor. Calling my name at night in the coven. Jesus never prayed.
Amen.
In Jesus never
prayed. Amen.
Amen. We're going to continue this prayer tomorrow. This one is a very terrible thing. This area is a very terrible thing. When we got to the village, before I will go to explain what happened before we got to the village, but before we got to the village, they told us that my father went to the village for the festival. Then there was one, somebody he offended, but they have little argument. My father is strong too, but I don't know what happened. It doesn't matter, they test themselves. But that very night, he ran away from the place. Run away from the place where they are doing the festival. There was not any other person they entered there.
Yes.
He went there and he went to go and carry something. They call it error. Error na.
Something to rob body.
Error na. Error is you know, when they throw something for you, something where they pull and I don't know whether for Benin. You know, when you go to the doctor, there's one pot where they cover. They pull leaf inside. When something they would use that, they maybe the person want that. They use that they the water they spray the person. So that the person go afford. I was for their life, maybe for come back in error. My father sprayed the thing for everybody, but he can't cool down small. They said somebody said, if he do this or something, or if they say my father give him this thing, May they bring anybody with them, may they bring the person up, come back to village. Person comes, come back to village. Please, my father died. They carry the cops, go back to the village.
Mm-hmm.
Say after me. Say after me. The last person. After me. Say my father, my father.
My father.
Witches and wizards.
Every wizard.
That want to kill me.
Every
member of my family. Against powers, against the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wickedness in high places. You are playing with this power. You better stop them before they stop you. Don't say as things they be. Don't say as things they be. This is a coronavirus. What would you say? What would you say? Put them out. There's white witchcraft. Why do they wear black suit? Now they watch them now. Go to YouTube, put witches. They add witch. You never see them for film. They ask wish. Just put film of wishes. You go see out there. You go see their manipulation. You see they wash me up. They start to deal with people. If you want to say which day, why you go there? Don't say which not day. Every wish we know may go forward. That wish go die by fire.
Amen.
That wish go die by correction.
Amen.
When you get your job, whether that wish of the year, whether domestic or international witchcraft, they go die by fire.
Amen.
First Corinthians chapter 11. When did they pay me? Say, please listen to me. When we started these 30 days together, we are almost 15, 16. Now only 11 with this one. Where are the four? When you start something, you must finish it. I was telling my mother, my mother was going to work. I said, we'll get, but I said, don't forget. When you start the book, Bob said, God is the beginning and the end. Put your earphone. The next prayer. Because not that you say, maybe God don't answer prayer. When you don't finish up.
Your wife is still working.
You must finish it. When you start, you must finish it. Okay, First Corinthians 11, verse 28, please. Let's do this so that we don't waste our time.
For I have received of the Lord that which also I deliver unto you. That the Lord Jesus, That the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread.
So Jesus, that same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, yes?
And when he gave it thanks, he broke it and said, Take it. This is my body which is broken for you.
This is my body that is broken for you.
This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup. When he had supped, saying. This is the cup. This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do as often as ye drink it in remembrance of me.
You are doing this as often in the remembrance of the Lord, yes?
For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup,
yes,
ye do show the Lord's death till he come.
You do show the Lord's death till he come.
Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily, shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself. So let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup.
And so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup. Now I want you to bow your head. I want you to examine yourself. Bow your head and examine yourself. Talk to God now. Ask him to forgive you. Ask him to forgive you. Every sin that you have committed, maybe at your working place, maybe concerning your wife, maybe your husband. Ask God to forgive you. Ask God to have mercy upon you. Ask God to cleanse you by the blood of Jesus. Father, thank you. Daddy, thank you. Lord, we come to you, Lord. Have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me. In the name of Jesus. Now, tell God what you want the Holy Communion to do for you. Tell God what you want the Holy Communion to do for you. Tell God what you want the Holy Communion to do for you. Tell God what you want the Holy Communion. You are blaming God for your healing. You are blaming God for your deliverance. You are blaming God for your miracle job, miracle document, miracle passport. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we declare this Holy Communion blessed.
Amen.
In the name of the Father.
Amen.
In the name of the Son.
Amen.
In the name of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now hold the bread in your hand. I don't know why some people are following us here. Because the people off their camera. Are you sure you are doing what we are doing here? So that tomorrow you say God will answer your prayer. But I don't understand. Are you sure you are following us? So just follow us there. So that we know that you are following us. We can know that God is with us.
I didn't touch you. That's why.
Hold your bread so that we can pray. We know that you are with us for the 30 days. Because I can know that we'll know where we'll feel, oh God. Some people go to the place, some people they sleep for bed. And they pray. Okay. See after me.
Come and see
us. Father, in the name of Jesus,
amen.
Let the power of God enter into this bread.
Amen.
Let the Spirit of God enter into this bread.
Amen.
Let the anointing of God enter into this bread.
Amen.
Let the blood of Jesus enter into this bread.
Amen.
Let the grace of God enter into this bread.
Amen.
Let this bread be shaped and turned to the body of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let the touch of power.
Amen.
Spirit of God.
Amen.
The touch
Amen.
Of the anointing of God.
Amen.
The touch of the grace of God. Lord, as we eat this bread, let the tabernacle and the temple of God come and dwell in our body. That sickness will not be able to stay in the body again. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, and everybody will say amen.
Amen.
Now get the foot of the man. Father, in the name of Jesus,
Amen.
Let the power of God enter into this food of the vine.
Amen.
Let the Spirit of God enter into this food of the vine.
Amen.
Let the anointing of God enter into this food of the vine.
Amen.
Let the blood of Jesus enter into this food of the vine.
Amen.
Let the grace of God enter into this food of the vine.
Amen.
Let it be changed and turned to the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Let it receive the touch of power.
Amen.
Let it receive the touch of the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Let it receive the touch of the anointing of God. Let them receive the touch of the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Let the angel that troubled the water of Bethesda trouble this blood now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That as we take this blood, Lord, let the spirit of death see this blood and run away.
Amen.
Let this pandemic called coronavirus see this blood and run away.
Amen.
Let sickness see this blood and run away.
Amen.
Let death see this blood and run away.
Amen.
Lord, this blood in cancer, in diabetes, Lord, whatever manners of sickness, let this blood heal, Lord. Lord, let this blood stand as a protection against the enemy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, and everybody will say amen.
Amen.
Let's bow our head as we give God thanks. opportunity. Bow your head and thank God for the opportunity to take this Holy Communion. Give him thanks, give him praise, give him honor, give him adoration. Worship him, worship him. Thank him, thank him, thank him, thank him. Father, thank you. Daddy, thank you. Daddy, thank you. Daddy, thank you. You are worthy, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
There's somebody here. I told you I'm not a prophet, oh, but my eyes is not blind. There's somebody here. I see. Look at what happened here. That is here, I should tell you. He said, all the enemies, all the witches that is pursuing you, they shall be relocated very soon. God saying, go relocate them. Go relocate them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
There's still somebody here. That is every time they're pursuing you in the dream. That is every power, everyone that is pursuing you in the dream, that to as you have prayed this prayer, they will begin to run away from you.
Amen.
Because there will be power to pursue them if so in the dream, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we give you praise, Lord.
Amen.
Take all the glory, Lord.
Amen.
Father, we see today's prayer by the blood of Jesus.
Blood of
Jesus. Father, we see today's prayer by the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Let everybody here come back with bundles of testimony.
Amen.
Let everybody receive that divine visitation.
Amen.
Let these 30 days turn things around for us, Lord.
Amen.
In the name of the Father.
Amen.
And the Son,
and
the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Let's share the grace together. The grace of God, the love of God, and the sweet voice of the Holy Spirit. Grace and abide with us now and forevermore. Before surely, did anybody have anything? Do you have any dream, anything that we need to pray with you? Please watch your dream, watch your dream, watch your dream, and then let us know about it. Please remember the Mary seminar is on Saturday, 4 p.m. to 5:20 p.m. Because immediately 5:20 by 5:30 we start the prayer, this fasting and prayer. We started by 5:30 to 6 p.m. So the Mary seminar is 4 p.m. to 5:20 p.m. Then we round it up in the church on Sunday. But the Saturday and Sunday program is starting 4 p.m. on Zoom. We're going to be on Zoom 4 p.m. to 5:20 p.m., the marriage seminar. Then 5:30, immediately, we start the prayer.
Questions.
Please, that's your questions that you need to ask, write everything out that Saturday. God will bless you in Jesus' name. About my marriage. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow all the days of my life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God bless you. Please invite other people to join us. We will hear your testimony very soon. In Jesus' name. God bless you. Timothy, call me now. Timothy, call me.
All right.